criminals being released to run wild and free? Will this create havoc? Will cities be set ablaze? Or as one attorney put it, is this the end of days? Let's talk on the mic. Hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people, it is 33 minutes past the hour, and yes, we are the voice of the everyday citizen. All right, good people, one of my subscribers sent me this story, asked me, have I heard of this? And I said, no. So I'm looking at this, right? And what is going on in the Midwest? Actually, also in the East, because I do believe New York has decided to do something like this also. But Illinois, I guess, is now catching on. So you let me know. This doesn't seem like a good idea, from my expert opinion, that is. So let's get to this story. When a new Illinois law takes effect next year, it will do away with the cash bail system in the state, meaning suspects charged with felonies, including second degree murder, aggravated battery, and arson, will be released without bail. Now, these are felonies, good people. These are serious charges, serious crimes, I might add. Now, the counter signal reports the Safety, Accountability, Fairness, and Equity Today Act, also called the Safety Act, would end cash bail and includes 12 non-detainable offenses, second-degree murder, aggravated battery, and arson without bail, as well as drug-induced homicide, kidnapping, burglary, robbery, intimidation, aggravated DUI, aggravated fleeing and eluding, drug offenses, and threatening a public official. Now, good people, when this law takes effect on January 1st, 2023, criminals charged with the crimes mentioned above, or I just mentioned, will be released without bail. They're going to let them out. The bail system will be replaced by a system that considers the offense severity, the risk of not appearing in court, and the potential threat to the community if a person is released, according to the Jacksonville Journal-Courier. When signing the legislation, Governor J.B. Pritzker, these Illinois names, Midwest names, I would say, remarked the measure marks a substantial step toward dismantling the systematic, this is what they call it, good people, racism that plagues our communities, our state, and our nation, and brings us closer to true safety, true fairness, and true justice, according to the outlet. Now see, this is what I do not understand. When a person has committed crimes such as second degree murder, aggravated battery, arson, setting fire to things, good people, kidnapping, burglary, robbery, intimidation, drug-induced homicide. Those individuals need to be locked up, in my professional opinion, because I've worked in law enforcement. When you have serious felonies such as the ones I just mentioned, they need to be locked up. Now, fleeing or something, you know, okay, I do understand. Certain misdemeanors, I do get it. I get it. Those I do understand. I do. But felonies such as the ones I mentioned, with the exception of a few. You know, aggravated fleeing, it depends, you know. That can go either way. Eluding drug offenses, that depends too, you see. But you talking homicide? Second degree murder? Arson? Are you serious? Supporters of the measure say it's a step in making the justice system equal and fair, especially for minority communities. There's no equality and fairness in the justice system, and it never will be. Now, House Chair of the Illinois Legislative Black Caucus, Representative Cam Buckner, Democrat out of Chicago, told Capital News Illinois that the Safety Act was the first stab at addressing public safety issues and police distrust in minority communities. The 800-page law also addresses detainee rights, police certification standards, use of force, and body cameras. But it's the ending of the cash bail system that's getting the most attention. Supporters of the law say the cash bail system is not fair for poor defendants, but a rising chorus of law enforcement officials and prosecutors across the Prairie State are sounding the alarm. No, no, no. The cash bail system is not fair for repeated offenses of individuals that commit certain acts, especially if they're minor. You see, like what happened in Missouri. You know, you're talking all these tickets and things and all of that. You know, if you're trying to boost your revenue by doing such things off of misdemeanors and such, then yeah. But these are serious felonies, some of these ones I mentioned. The state attorney says it will be the end of days when this law goes into effect. That's what I just quoted earlier. Will County State's Attorney James Glasgow said in a YouTube video, it will be the end of days once the law kicks in. He says the hands of police, prosecutors, and judges will be tied. What you see in Chicago, we'll have here, Glasgow said. Glasgow said he won't be able to hold people longer than 3 months if they demand trial. On the 90th day, they get out, no matter what crime they committed. The state attorney said, this is what will occur. He called on voters to demand of anyone running for election in November to repeal the measure. Those who support the new law said the current system imposes a different justice system on defendants who can afford their bond compared to those who cannot. While we agree that a person's freedom should not depend on their bank account, completely eliminating the current system was never the answer, they said. Actually, you know, I don't understand this, because what do they need to really post bond for? Bail, so they can jump it? Why don't they sit there until the trial? What's the problem? Are you going to do what you were doing, is spending more money getting them out, and then they go to court, take a plea, probably get on probation, and then you have more fees? You're going to put them back out on the street. Utterly ridiculous. Abolishing cash bail means that every person that is being held in jail awaiting trial will have their bonds exonerated and community safety will be put at risk, the statement read. I'm inclined to agree. The three Brown County officials noted the new law is full of contradictions, full of ambiguities, and is very poorly drafted. Lawyers across the state are all scratching their heads, wondering how the new system is going to work and keep people safe, the statement continued. Additionally, beginning January 1st, 2023, judges will no longer be allowed to consider the person's threat to the community. Serial domestic abusers, sex offenders, and residential burglars will be set free without judges being allowed to consider public safety generally, unless the prosecution can prove by clear and convincing evidence that the accused possess a real and present threat to a specific person, and no condition can mitigate the threat, the statement noted. The three officials concluded their statement by saying they didn't want to incite fear, but to educate the public on the reality coming on January 1st. Well, I believe it's a little late for that because fear is already here. When someone commits a crime in Illinois, the person shall not be held in jail, absent extreme circumstances, the statement read. An Illinois Supreme Court commission that studied the state's pretrial system for 2 years released a report in 2020 noting, simply eliminating cash bond at the outset without first implementing meaningful reforms and dedicating adequate resources to allow evidence-based risk assessment and supervision would be premature. And as you can see, this is the letter released. Now, Patrick Windhorst, former state's attorney and current state representative, voted against this bill when it came about. He said he was one of the leading voices against it. And also the Johnson County Sheriff agreed with Windhorst. Anyone sitting in jail right now with all these pending charges, they're going to be let out. Johnson County Sheriff Peter, was it Sopsack? God, Illinois, man, Midwest. According to the sheriff, the gates are open and they're going to be let out onto the streets, unquote. And there you have it. Will this help or destroy this city? So I guess we will have to wait and see come January 2023. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night.
They'll understand you soon, it won't be long. Keep on, keep running.